Hello and welcome back to this series of tutorials on using GeoGebra for mathematics explorations. So far we have seen how to label, display and format an object, how to use a text box and an input bar, and how to construct sliders and input boxes. In this tutorial we'll be looking at the use of a checkbox in GeoGebra. Checkbox is a feature by which you can show or hide objects in a GeoGebra construction. And every object in the construction can be linked to a checkbox. This is useful when you would like to, say, direct the flow of a lesson, when you would like to pause, when you want to show something or hide something and use that opportunity for discussion or demonstrate properties by varying, etc. And this is very useful in a classroom context when you would like to structure a lesson. In this tutorial, we will look at a sample file that's already been created with checkboxes to see the various different uses to which you can put checkboxes. And then we will also construct a simple checkbox during the course of this tutorial. So this is quite straightforward. There are a triangle, area of a triangle, to calculate the area of a triangle. So the sliders can vary the side length. And the area will be calculated. So, I mean, if you just change it a little bit, you can see that the area is changing, and all of which you know how to do. Now, our interest is in this panel here, where you see these little boxes here and some text which is showing on the side. These are checkboxes. And when you click or you don't click a checkbox, something in the construction will get displayed or not. So, for instance, let's say I do show line for the side AB. So you can now see that a line becomes visible. You plot point on the line K and show the angle. So it is plotted a point on line K and it is also showing the angle. Now what's interesting is you can also show here called the show teacher notes. So here the notes tell the teacher what to do. Move the point G on the line K, move the slider for the size and observe what happens to the altitude. So therefore you kind of move this point, it is telling you what to do, so you can do that. So you can move the point G and then see what happens, and that's the flow of the lesson. But our interest now is in seeing how to construct the checkbox. So I will unhide the notes and I will unhide everything and go back to how has this been done. So now we will go to algebra view, and in algebra view you can see that in this panel here, there is something called Boolean value. There are five Boolean variables that have been defined in the GeoGebra construction. We all know what Boolean variables are. So now when it takes a value true or false. True is when the object is selected and false is when the object is unselected. So when I take my mouse near the checkbox, you can see a small, you know, window that is appearing. A pop-up kind of a thing which says Boolean value F. When I take it to the next one, it says Boolean value H. It will also be highlighted on the algebra panel, if you can see to the left. Right, you can see it here, you can also see it here. Then you can see here Boolean value J, Boolean value M, and so on. Now, let us check this so the line becomes visible. And let us also plot the point G and then the angle becomes visible. So now, we also want to go and see the objects here. This is the object that has become visible now. So if you go and check the property here, it will show you in advance, condition to show the object is F. That means when the F Boolean variable is taking the value true, that means when the checkbox is checked, this line displays. Similarly, let's check out the point G. If you go to the object properties, the condition under which it will be shown is when H is equal to true, when the Boolean variable H becomes true. And similarly, the angle alpha also is linked to the Boolean variable H. So how do you look for this? You can go to the object properties in any object that you construct. Under advanced, you will find that the condition to show the object. Here, there is no condition associated with the circle which has been used for the triangle construction. So, it's not showing. However, this line K, there is a condition associated, right? So, this is how checkboxes can be used. And we saw, for instance, that even the teacher notes, it can even be associated with the text box that you have constructed. So, show notes, that becomes another Boolean variable. So, if you go see here, the boolean variable is n. So if I I just click here, if I see it here, the boolean variable associated with the show notes checkbox is n, and you can see that it is n is equal to true, and then these are the variables that have been associated. So let us click here and see. Condition to show object is n, right? So this is how checkboxes actually work. So now let's just do a small construction of a checkbox to get practice with the whole technique. So now there is a simple two line segments here which are making an angle with each other. I want to use a checkbox to say show angle, right? No, not a slider, sorry, a checkbox, show angle, and you select the angle here. Now what you must remember is that the object should have already been constructed by you. From within the checkbox you cannot make any construction. You can only associate an already constructed object with the input using the checkbox. And now you say apply. So you use the move button always. So you say show angle. Now you don't show the angle, it doesn't show. The boolean value is C. C is equal to false. When I click on it, boolean value is equal to C. C is equal to true. Now let's say I want to also show the segment, right? Now can I add it to this checkbox? No, you cannot do. You cannot add objects to a checkbox after it has been constructed. You need to do it one more time. So therefore, when we are planning a lesson, we need to sort of think through how we want to display things up front itself, right? So now I'll do this, and then I will get into a checkbox here, right? I'll say show angle and opposite side, right? So then, and also when you're doing it, you can keep it here so that you can see the construction. So you can move it like this so you can see the construction. Show angle and opposite side. And you say angle alpha and segment D, which is the segment D, right? So you say apply. So now use the move button. Boolean value C. C is now equal to true. It's visible. So if you uncheck it, C becomes false. It is not displayed anymore. So it's a very simple thing really, and with this you can really explore GeoGebra very effectively for teaching concepts in a classroom. So I hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and wish you lots of fun with GeoGebra constructions.